believe that targeted vaccination mandates are now a very important strategy for quickly raising vaccination coverage across our county and ending the pandemic. And we applaud the president, our governor, the board of supervisors, our cities and school districts, and business establishments for creating additional safety at spaces where people are intermingling by using targeted vaccination mandates. We are prepared to move forward later this week with a modified health officer order that would require verification at vaccination at select high-risk settings. This modified health officer order would include aligning with President Biden and requiring vaccination verification or a negative test within 72 hours prior to attending an outdoor mega event for both participants and employees. Attendees at indoor mega events already are required to share vaccination verification or a negative test result. Many mega event venues established verification systems during the spring in response to previous capacity restrictions, and we're prepared to offer all large venues and organizers of mega events technical assistance to assist with any implementation challenges. Vaccine verification would also be required for customers and employees at indoor portions of bars, wineries, breweries, nightclubs, and lounges. This is to say drinking establishments that have either no restaurant permit or a low-risk restaurant permit. All these establishments are for adults only, and they already require patrons to show identification. We'll prepare toolkits that businesses can use to help them confirm vaccinations, and we'll be providing education and support to these establishments who are requesting assistance. While not required, we do recommend vaccination verification at indoor portions of restaurants. Our implementation timeline would require that outdoor mega events comply by October 7th. Bars, nightclubs, breweries, wineries, and lounges would require customers and employees to have at least one dose of the vaccine by October 7th and both doses by November 4th. This modified health officer order aligns with the continued need to reduce risk for transmission and increase vaccination coverage. This is a reasonable path forward that can position us to be better able to break the cycle of surges. Thank you, and I remain available to answer questions after the presentation.